A very good morning to all the students. Today I am going to present a topic, potential appraisal. This is one of the important topic from unit number 3, and it is one of the contemporary issue in the performance management. And let us just start with the meaning of the potential appraisal. It is an appraisal of a person's present competencies which are not applied on the present job. It is the identification of the hidden talent and skills of a person. The person might or might not be aware of them. It is always there, like with the employees, sometimes they do not use certain of their skills in their present job. So when the management tries to just explore the hidden skills of the employees so that they can be promoted to the next senior level job, that kind of exercise can be called as the potential appraisal. Potential appraisal may also be defined as a process of determining an employee's strength and weaknesses with a view to use this as a predictor of the future performance. Why there is a need of the potential appraisal? Actually, whatever the kind of the methods we are using for appraising the performances of the employees are all based on their current performances. But for the succession planning or just to promote the people on the future jobs, on the higher level jobs, it is very much essential just to check the kind of the skills that are available with them, with which they can just do the job properly. So there is a need of the potential appraisal. It is just required to inform the employees about their future prospects. It helps the organization chalk out of a suitable succession plan. So here you can see this diagram. People are like an iceberg, like the whatever you can see as their performance, that is visible upwards, but there is a lot of the hidden potential that is available with some of the people, and they can just do miracles for the company. So that's why hidden potential is needed to be explored by the company people, and there is a need for the potential appraisal in the companies. Like whenever we talk about the characteristics of the potential appraisal, it is the process of identifying hidden skills and abilities. It is the time like when the companies should just go for the kind of the exercises like the potential appraisal. It is future oriented process. It is a part of the performance appraisal, and it does not guarantee promotion. There are a lot of differences in between the potential appraisal and the performance appraisal. Potential appraisal is for future. It is a forward looking process, while performance appraisal is backward looking process. Potential appraisal is done to explore the hidden potential of an employee. Management by objective is one of the technique just to go with it. While performance appraisal is done after the completion of some task or project assigned, and it checks how you fared in those tasks. There are a lot of methods that can be utilized for the performance appraisal. It includes the ranking method, the rating method, etc. The activity of potential appraisal is associated with competencies, while performance appraisal is associated with the key performance areas. The time period for appraisal potential is uncertain, while for performance appraisal, it is usually done half yearly, quarterly, or after a fixed period of time. So these all are the differences in between the potential appraisal and the performance appraisal. When we talk about the process of the potential appraisal, there are few steps. Number one is the role description. First, the organization should precisely mention the kind of the role for which they are looking for some good person, or they want to promote some person on that particular job. Then the organization should just also work on the qualities that are required to perform that particular role. The qualities may be divided into the four categories. It can be the technical knowledge and skills, it can be the managerial capabilities, it can be the behavioral capabilities, and it can be the conceptual capabilities. Then the organization should also work in advance on the rating mechanism, like rating by others, psychological tests, simulation games, and performance appraisal records. Once all the three steps have been covered by the functional head, that is the HR manager, the next important step is organizing the system, the like generating the kind of the indicators, generating the kind of the potential appraisal system, and to just organize it properly. And at last, the feedback must be given to all the employees on whom these exercises have been done. Obviously, the people, those who are good in the qualities and those who have got good grading and the rating, they just pass the test and they can be promoted to the future and the senior jobs. So this is the process. There are two approaches of the potential appraisal: helicopter method and the whole person qualities method. The helicopter tries to measure the potentiality of a person in terms of large as well as specific issues, while the whole person quality method includes the wholesome qualities and potentialities of a person. There are a lot of the companies, those who are using the potential appraisal system, and we will discuss all these kind of the systems in our next class. Thank you.